Bismillahirrahmanirrahim, and welcome back to this next video. And this is the third and the last video on the first and the second messengers. In my previous two videos, I focused on the first messengers first and then on the second messengers. So this table is going to show you the differences between the first and the second messengers. So if you define the first messengers, they are actually the extracellular signaling molecules which bind with their respective receptors and initiate intracellular activities within the cell. When you talk about the secondary messengers, in contrast to the first messengers, they are not extracellular, they are intracellular molecules that send signals from the receptors. They are activated by the first messengers, and when they are activated, they are going to target and trigger physiological processes of the cell. If you talk about the location, as I've told you, the first messenger, they are the extracellular molecules. The second messenger, they are the intracellular molecules. How they operate? The first messenger operate by binding to their respective receptors. What the second messengers do is, they, through activation of their respective kinase, they are going to perform their important functions. The examples from the first messenger family, there can be hormones, there can be neurotransmitters, etc. When you talk about the examples from the second messengers, there can be cyclic AMP, there can be cyclic GMP and calcium, etc. But as I've told you in my last video, keep in mind one thing, that it is actually the coordination of the first and the second messengers that are responsible for the physiological processes required for the cell at that particular time. And they are not working in isolation. So the first and the second messenger, or their coordination, is actually causing the required changes in the cell at a given time. So if you like the video, please subscribe to my channel, hit the like button and share it with your friends.